Hello, hello, hello. Alright guys, I'm pretty shocked this actually worked. So, in the last video that I uploaded, I showed you my tape deck that I got, this realistic aftermarket under-dash standalone cassette player, and I just spent all weekend installing it, and it took a lot longer than I thought it did because they lied to me. The box says that it includes all the mounting hardware, and it didn't. Now, it's possible that the person who sold it to me took it out of the box, but, you know, that's kind of unlikely since the tape was still on it when I bought it, and I had to peel the tape off, so unless they resealed it just to get the mounting hardware. But then I read in the manual somewhere that it says you have to buy a separate kit for the mounting hardware, so it lied. It's stupid, but anyway, I had to take the radio into Ace Hardware and figure out what screws it went in and all that stuff. And then I went to install it, and the wiring diagram that it supplies for you for how this thing is installed is kind of confusing. It wants you to wire it up in parallel with the radio constant switched 12-volt supply, which means that the tape player is always on no matter what, even when there's no tape in it, which it won't play any sound when there's no tape in it because of the way that the machine works. But it still means that it's constantly drawing power even when you're not playing any music, which is kind of scary to me because if I were to want to listen to the radio, obviously we're not going to get any reception because we're in a garage, but you know, if I wanted to listen to the radio, I'd worry about blowing the fuse out of the tape deck because it's technically they're both playing out of the same speakers at the same time, so it was a little, I was a little worried about it, but as you can see, look at that. I got the tape deck installed, and it does work miraculously. Some people on Reddit, when I posted about this, some people said, well, the belt is probably, you know, worn out and crappy anyway, but I was a little bit skeptical of those people because I've bought several aftermarket tape decks, and the belts were fine, besides that Jensen, but that thing sat in a junkyard. Anyway, so it does work. It's actually got really good audio quality. I don't even have the volume cranked halfway up, and it's pretty loud. It's nice, I gotta say. It's really nice. So I've got a tape here, and I'm gonna play it for you. It's Elvis, Blue Hawaii, from the movie that I've never seen. The soundtrack's okay. This tape got eaten once before. It was kind of crinkly. So I figured, what the hell? If I put it in and it eats it, the tape was wrecked anyway. But it didn't. It actually played it, and it played it really damn well. And I'm not going to bother only playing part of it, because last time I did a sound quality video, it got copyright striked anyway, and it's not like I'm trying to make money off of this, so who cares, right? So here we go. Of course, the song ends when I start demonstrating the sound quality. It sounds really good. It sounds crisp. It's a lot better quality than I expected out of a radio, you know, cassette player from like the late 60s. It's really a good quality. I mean, I don't know. I'm happy with it. I am happy with that outcome. That is, that's more than I could have hoped for. I was really afraid that I was going to stick a tape in and I was either going to eat it or wasn't going to play it or was going to blow the fuse right away. But none of that stuff happened, and it actually ended up being really nice. So yeah, that is the realistic under-dash standalone cassette player. And I did, you know, it is in a fairly good spot too. I mean, my feet aren't going to hit that when I'm switching pedals, and you know, it's way out of the way. I'd have to really kick up to hit that, and I don't drive that recklessly, so That's not going to happen. And it's out of the way of the heater. Heater's actually back there, so it's not going to get heat blown on it. And the ashtray is still operational, even with the cassette deck there. So I'm happy. I got it to work the way I want it to. So on to the next project here. I'll see you then.